What is good, Horror Horror? This is your boy, Horror Gamer, back with another video for you. And as you can tell by the title of this video, we are doing another Is It Worth the Hate? And holy shit, I may have one of the most unanimously hated movies ever to grace the silver screen. And as you can tell by the title of this movie, yeah, it's a fucking doozer. But before I get into this, just know that your boy Horror Gamer's reviews and Is It Worth the Hate have spoilers in them all day, every day. So if you haven't seen this movie, go watch the movie, come back, let me know in the comment section what you think, whether you agree with me, whether you disagree with me, whether you think I'm full of shit, you know, whatever. So with all that being said, Horror Horde, anything beyond this point is on you. So, like I said, as you can tell in the title of this video, we're going to be doing the 1998 remake, I think it was a remake, I don't know what it was, of Boom! Godzilla. And boy, I can feel the hate just coming through the monitor here, guys. Now, but this movie right here had been destroyed by critics and by fans alike because of the way they made Godzilla, the way they portrayed Godzilla in the back, how he was, and all this other shit. So, is Godzilla worth the hate? The Matthew Broderick 1998 theatrical Godzilla, is it worth the hate? Hell no. And I know, whoa, come on now, hear me out. This movie right here was on point on so many levels for me. The CGI was on point. The soundtrack was on point. And the acting was very well, it was a very well acted movie. The only reason people hated this movie was how Godzilla looked, let's just be honest, and that it had babies at the end or whatever. But the main thing was the way Godzilla looked. Yeah, I wasn't a fan of how they had Godzilla look in this one. Kind of looked like a giant, like iguana or some shit like that. But the CGI in this movie was just fucking phenomenal. Like, it looked so real. Like, the scene where he's walking through the city and the guy is running and he looks up and you just see his feet and you just see him walking and turning the corner and you see the tail. Some of the realest looking CGI for 1998. This was made back in 1998. Some of the best CGI you will see. This right here, in my opinion, is the standard on how CGI should be done because it looks so real. It was just, it was a phenomenally made movie. In my opinion, I love this movie. This is, I know I'm gonna get a lot of shit for this next comment, and it's okay. You know, we're all here to give our opinions, and I respect everybody's opinion. This is one of my favorite Godzilla films. Now, granted, I've seen some of the older ones, and you can't fuck with the older ones. I get that, they're classics. But for me, this right here, it was a good movie. Like, granted, Godzilla looked like a giant lizard, but it was a good movie. The roar was on point. Fucking him destroying the city. Yeah, the part with Madison Square Garden at the end was kind of wishy-washy for me. But all in all, the movie was not bad. It wasn't a bad movie. It was just a lot of your Godzilla fanboys just hated the way Godzilla looked, period. That was the main reason why a lot of people hated this movie. And I'm just being honest. I know a lot of people hated the movie because of the way he looked. And that was the way, you know, people told me why they hated the movie. But as for movie-wise, as for production, as for soundtrack, it was on point. Like, this movie was on point. And the acting, Matthew Broderick was good in this. The girl, she was kind of annoying. It is what it is. And then you had the guy from The Professional, the Jean, I forget his name. Ah, shit. He was really good in it, too. And like I said, just the CGI, the way Godzilla tore this city up, and that scene towards the end when the helicopter's flying over looking for him and they can't find him, and then You just see Godzilla's head come up, grab the helicopter explodes. That scene terrified me as a kid because you couldn't see Godzilla anywhere. Godzilla was gone. He was out, bizzed out. And they're like, where is he now? Wham! Jumped up from beneath him and just ate the helicopter. So well done. Like that scene, and it was in slow motion. It was so well done. I love this movie. This movie right here was one of my favorites as a kid. It introduced me to a new level of Godzilla. Because like I said, the older stuff's really good too. You know, it's practical, which is alright. That's alright with me. That's how it was back then. But this one used a lot of CGI. And it done it very well. It was a very well made movie. I just don't see, besides the way Godzilla looked, the hate that it gets, because like I said, it wasn't bad. I thought it was fun. I actually thoroughly enjoyed it, and I might watch it again and do a review on it soon. So, but all in all, Horror Horde, it was fun. It was fast paced. Godzilla just was tearing shit up. Godzilla did what Godzilla does best, tear shit up, and then just destroys everything. And it was fun. So, is Godzilla, final verdict, is Godzilla 1998 Matthew Broderick Godzilla worth the hate? Absolutely not. I'm telling you, go back, watch it with my points. Look at the CGI, listen to the soundtrack, look at the acting, and just give it a legit shot. You know what I mean? Now you know what you're getting. You know what you're getting with this. Go back, watch it, give it another try. I'm not going to guarantee you, but I'm going to go on a limb here and say you'll probably kind of change your mind about it a little bit. I mean, if you're a diehard Godzilla fanboy, you're going to hate it no matter what, because it doesn't follow the original Godzilla narrative. So you're going to hate it. It is what it is, but I'm telling you, just give it another shot, watch it for what it is, and I think you'll enjoy it. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So, alright, Horror Horde, with all that being said, Godzilla 1998, definitely not worth the hate, in my opinion. So, hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it for you, and don't forget, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button, along with that dingly-ding-ding button, that way every time your boy Horror Gamer throws up one of these is it worth the hate or a review or an unboxing or a creepypasta theater or a Legends of, you're always in the know. So with all that being said, Horror Horde, this is your boy Horror Gamer saying until next time, don't fear the darkness, embrace it.